Hello students, today we are going to study the convolution code. So the convolution code, its encoding can be done by the code tree, trait transition diagram and predict diagram. And the decoding can be done by the Viterbi algorithm and sequential decoding. So the code tree, the first method of the encoding of the convolution code is nothing but the code tree. Some basic parameters for the code tree is small n is the code length, K is the message bit, L is the number of output bits, and some features of the convolution codes are the code tree is highly secure code, and the number of error corrections are also high in, as compared to the linear block code. For the code tree, the code length or code efficiency can be evaluated by K divided by N, where N is approximately, small n is approximately, code length is approximately K into N, that is message bit into the output, number of output bits. So N can be defined in this way, N is equal to N plus K minus 1 multiplied by L. For the case of K, message bit should be greater than N, that is a number of shift registers. So your message bit should be greater than the number of shift registers. So in this case, the N is approximately equal to the K minus K into N. So let us take one encoder. So encoder is N, there are three shift registers, and the entered message bit is 1101, and the two output states are X1 and X2. As per the diagram, the X1 can be defined as the M0 plus XOR with M1 XOR with M2, and X2 is nothing but the M0 XOR with the M2. Here the M2 is the current state and M0 and M1 are the previous states. Right. So in this case the output capital X is equal to X1, X2, X1, X2 like this. So you can draw the state complete state diagram. M0, M1, M2 and X1, X2 are the outputs. Suppose if the first clock pulse is given to the encoder, so this one bit is entered into the M2. Initially M0 and M1 are the 00. So first bit M1 is entered, so M1 and M0 are the 00. So X1 is nothing but the M0 XOR with M1 XOR with M2, so it is 1. And X2 is nothing but the M0 XOR with the M2, so it is also 1. So this 1 is shifted to the next shift register, and this 0 is also for, shifted for the next shift register. So for the next clock pulse, this 1 is shifted here and this 0 is shifted to the M0. And the next bit is 1, so 1 is entered into the M1, M2. So the X can you can calculate the X1 is a 0 and X2 is a 1. Again 1 is shifted to M1 and this 1 is shifted to the M0, and the next bit is 0, so it is entered into the M2. So you will get the X1 and X2 as a 0, 1. So again this 0 is next bit is 1, which is entered into the M2. M2 bit is shifted to the M1 and M1 bit shifted to the M0. So it becomes 1 is entered into the M2, so the last bit is shifted to the M1 and the M1 bit is shifted to the M0. So you will get the 00 output. Again this 1 is shifted to the, for the next clock pulse the bit is 0. Right. So bit is 0. So this 1 is shifted to here and this 0 is shifted to here. So you will get the output 10. Again this shift for the next clock pulse, because this last 1 is should be entered into the your last shift register, that is M0. So you have to shift for the next two clock pulse also. So this 0 is entered here and this 1 is entered here. So in this way you will get the 1 1. So you can evaluate the output 1 1 0 1 0 1 0 0 1 0 and 1 1. So 1 1 0 1 0 1 0 0 1 0 and 1 1. So you can check for the, verify for the n bits. N is equal to n plus k minus 1 into the L. L is the total output bits. So total output bits are the X1, X2. So that is 1. N is the capital N is the number of shift registers, so which is a 3. 4 are the message bits, so 4, so 3 plus 4 minus 1 multiplied by 2, so 7 minus 1 multiplied by 2, so 6 into 2, so it becomes 12. So these are the 12 bits available at the end of the encoder. So 1, 1, 0, 1, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and 12, so 12 bits are available. Okay, so let us check the example for the code diagram, code tree diagram and its decoding. So take the same encoder with the different message 1010. So M0, M1, M2. M2 is the current shift register and M1 and M0 are the previous two shift register. X1 is the module to addition of M0, M1 and M2, and X2 is module to addition of M0 and M2. Right. So draw the code tree and decode the same for the message 1010. Here the given data is K is the message bits, L is the two output bits X1, X2 and 3 is the number of shift register. So N will be 3 plus 4 minus 1 multiplied by 2. So 3 is the number of shift register, 4 are the message bits minus 1 into 2. So 12 will be the your total length of the code word. And the efficiency is K divided by N. So 4 divided by 4 are the message bits divided by 12 are your total number of bits. So 4 divided by 12 is nothing but the 1 by 3. So your efficiency will be 1 by 3. Right. Draw the state table. So state table. So clock pulse M0, M1, M2. M2 is the your current shift register. M1 is previous last shift register and this is also last shift register, right? So the message bits, one is entered into the M2, one is entered into M2, so the last previous two bits was 0, right? So 0 0 1, so your X1 will be 1 and X2 will be the 1. Again this one is shifted here and this 0 is shifted here. So your state will be the 0 1 0, because next bit is 0 which is entered into the M2. So the next bit is 0 which is entered into the M2. This one is shifted here and this 0 is shifted here. So your output will be 0 XOR with 1 XOR with 0. So 1 and the 0. Right. Again the third bit is 1 which is entered into the M2. And so this 0 is shifted M1 and this one is shifted here. So the output will be 0 0. Again the last bit 0 is entered into the M2, so this one is shifted here and this 0 is shifted here, so the output is the 1 0. Again this last bit should be at the extracted at the M0 point. So for you can use the two clock pulses extra. So the 0, the one more extra 0 is added here. So this 0 is shifted here and this 1 is shifted here. Again the output is 1 1. Again for the next bit is entered as a 0 in M2, so this 0 is shifted here and this 0 is shifted here. So your last bit 1 0 1 0 was the your message bit, so that 0 is at the last flip-flop register or shift register, so 0, and the output will be 0 0. So your X will be from the table 1 1 1 0 0 0 1 0 1 1 and 0 0. So you can draw the transition diagram as we already checked in the convolution code basics. So current state is the M2 and the last previous states are the M0, M1. A, B, C, D are the your state, transition state. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. So if M0 and M1 are the 0 0, so state will be the 0 depending upon the bits in the M2, whether M2 is 0 or 1. So for the B you can use the state M0 1, for the C you can use the state 1 0, and for D you can use the 1 1. It is used for the code tree. Okay, so let us check for the state A. State A, your current state will be of M2, 0 or either 1. If it is 0, so go in upward direction. If it is 1, go in lower direction. And your current state for the A,
previous state shift register are the 00. So 00, M0 and M1 should be 00 for the 0 M2 state, and for the 1 state also it should be the 00. So for this case, the X1 is the module 2 addition. I repeat here, X1 is the M0 XOR with M1 XOR with M2, and X2 is M0 as for this M0 XOR with M2, right? So here the 3 bits 000 module 2 addition for the X1, so 0 XOR with 0 XOR with 0, so it becomes 0, and for the X2 M2 XOR with M0, this bit, so 0 XOR with 0, so it against 0. When M2 bit is 1, if for the state M2 bit is 1, so M0 and M1 is again 00, so X1 will become 1 XOR with 0 1, 1 XOR with 0 1, so X1 will be 1, and X2 will be M0 XOR with M2. M0 bit is 0 and M2 bit is 1, so 1 XOR with 0, so it is again 1. Means it indicates that when state for this transition state A, when M2 bit is 0, it goes to the upward direction as a 00, because these two bits are the 0, and if it is 1, M2 bit is 1, so it is 11, so 11. So in this way you can calculate for the B M2 when 0 and M2 when 1, and transition state for the B is 01. So 0101. So you can evaluate these three bits for the X1, X2, and these three bits for the X1, X2. So in this way you will get for the B, for the 0 upward direction 10, and for the lower direction 01. For the C, M2 bit is 0, M2 bit is 1. For the C transition it is 10. So 1010. So calculate this X1, X2 for the 0 bit, M2 0 bit, and when M2 is equal to 1, you can calculate the X1, X2 bit. So in this way, you will get the 11 and 01. Similarly, for the D bit 00, 01, state will be the change 11 and 11. So D bit 11 and 11. So evaluate this for X1, X2 for the M2 is equal to 0, and evaluate this M2 is equal to 1. So X1, X2. So X1, X2 for the upward direction 01, for the lower direction 10. So 01 and 10. So by using this state table, you can evaluate the code tree or draw the code tree. So for the code tree, the K are the message bits, K is equal to 4. So 2 raised to K or 2 raised to 4 is equal to 16 codes are there. So 16 codes are there, so it becomes 4 times 0 to the 4 times 1. Right. So code tree diagram is nothing but the tree diagram which flows from or flows horizontally. So normal tree is top to bottom, but it is left to right code tree. So this is the diagram for code tree. So the 8 are the possible out 16 are the possible output 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 8 times 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and 8. So draw the codes. First of all, 4 times 0 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 1 1 0 0 1 1 1 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 1 9 10 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 1 So in this way you can draw the write the code words for 16 bits code word for from 4 times 0 to the 4 times 1. So these are the 16 codes. So attach these two codes, combine these two codes, again combine, again combine. So you will get that the end one branch is there. Okay, so this is the first point when code word is 0. So it is in upward direction. When code word is 1, so it is in the lower direction. Assign the transition state A and this transition state is B. Initially this transition is, we can call it as A. Again this transition state is A, this transition state is B, this transition state is C, and this transition state is D. Again this transition state is A, this transition state is B, this transition state is C, this transition state is D. Again this is A, this is B, this is C, and this is D. So this is the one of the structure for the code tree. So now assign the codes to the code tree. So we already evaluated for the A state when 0 for the upward direction and is 1 for the lower direction. So you can, so for the A state, when A is in the upward direction, so it is 0, and A is lower direction, it is 1 1. So when start with this point, so A to A, so in upward direction, so it is 0 0. So as you evaluated this, and when A is in the lower direction, it is 1 1. So at this point, when A is in upward direction, again the code will be the 0 0. When A in the lower direction, the code will be the 1 1. At this point again, A to A, so A in upward direction, so 0 0. A in lower direction, it is so it is 1 1. So we already evaluated. Again A in upward direction, so 0 0. A in the lower direction, it is 1 1, right? So at this point you have to assign the codes when B is in upward direction. So you already evaluated the code for the B. When B is in the upward direction, so it is 1 0, and B is lower direction, it is 0 1. So you can assign this code 1 0 and 0 1. When B is in upward direction, 1 0, B is in the lower direction, 0 1. Again here B is in the upward direction, 1 0, and B is in the lower direction, 0 1. Again for the C, when C is in the upward direction, 1 1, and C is in the lower direction, 0 0. So C is in the upward direction, 1 1 and 0 0. C is in the upward direction, 1 1, and it is a 0 0 in the lower direction. Again here the point B, when B is in the upward direction, 1 0, and the B is in the lower direction, 0 1. Again C is in the upward direction, 1 1, and C is in the lower direction, 0 0. A again upward direction, 0 0, low downward direction, 1 1. D is in the upward direction, 0 1, and lower direction, 1 0. 0 1 and 1 0. Again A 0 0 1 0. B in upward direction, 1 0 and 0 1. C is in the upward direction, 1 1 0 0. D is in the upward direction, 0 1 and 1 0. So in this here the C, D is remaining. D is in the upward direction, 0 1 and 1 0. 0 1 and 0 1 and 1 0. So all codes are assigned to this code tree. So we already evaluated the X for the from the output table. So from the output table, x was 1 1 1 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 0 0 1 0 1 1 and 0 0. So this is from this output is from your table. So this table, transitions table. Now you have to decode for the message 1 0 1 0. So you can draw the decoding message for the x. So x 1 0 1 0. 1 means the downward direction and 0 means upward direction. Okay, so at start with this point, so 1 is the first bit, so go to the downward direction. So first of all, draw the path. So draw the path for 1 0 1 0 bit. So start with this point. So 1 means first bit is 1, so go to the downward direction. Again, next bit is, second bit is 0, so go to the upward direction, reach here. Again, third bit is 1, so go to the again downward direction, reach at this point. Again, fourth bit is 0, so this is your final code word 1 0 1 0. So this is the decoding of the code tree. The advantage of code tree is the encoding and decoding done in the same method. Okay, so your x for this path, so the evaluated x from the code tree will become, so this is the first code 1 1, next path arising code is 1 0, next code path arising is 0 0, next path is 1 0 1 0. So 1 0 and 1 0, right? So these are the 12 bits we can generate from the code tree. Thank you.